thing. There's a vision that I put just made for you. You don't share with everybody. There's a dream that God will give to you just for you to pray. Pray through all your dreams this year. And my sister, we believe that God will come through in Jesus' name. Yes, my dream will come true.
My dream will come true.
Joseph suffered a lot. He didn't do anything wrong. He was a dreamer, for God's sake. They took him, they burned him, they put him in a pit. From the pit, they took him, and they took him to his soul. The government passed out, eventually he landed in the prison. And from the prison, God gave him a new deliverance. Within 24 hours, God got things around for Joseph. God got things around for his dream. God got things around in his life. There is a God. God, the God of Joseph. That God will visit you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This God, he changed season. He changed time for Joseph. He doesn't need a whole year to give you a new vision. No. Within 24 hours, somebody that was languishing in jail, somebody that was put in a inner prison, in a hurry, because heaven has commanded to leave.
Hallelujah.
Heaven has commanded the release of your blessings in Jesus' name.
Amen.
All your blessings will be released unto you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because heaven has commanded his release. No man, nobody can hold him. He was released. They changed him. They cut his beard. They removed his beard. They put a new remnant upon his life.
Hallelujah.
Tell me, it's not one. And didn't tell me. Hallelujah. Okay, I can hear myself now. You can hear. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know what you have been through. Maybe your story is like the story of Joseph. I don't know. Maybe you have been through afflictions since the beginning of your life. Like Joseph, you have moved from pit to prison. I have an announcement to make to you. God Almighty, who is God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, who is God, the God of Joseph, is about to bring you to your palace.
Amen.
This year you will enter into your palace.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, you will enter into glory. You move from glory unto glory. In the name of Jesus. He can change times. He can change season. I don't know your story, but I know there is a God. I know there is a God who cannot fail. I know there is a God who knows all things. I know there is a God who is God, the God of Israel. A God who delivered the children of Israel from captivity of 430 years. Not only can he give an individual a new beginning, he can give a nation a new beginning. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't know what your family is going through. God will give you a new beginning in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I know this God who can give a nation, this nation called Israel. They have been going through captivity, generational captivity. For 430 years, they have been to hard labor, terrible things. They have been beaten. They have been working for miniature wages. They have been working and nothing to show for it. The Egyptian rode on their back. Hallelujah. But a year came, like this year. A day came, like today, that God decreed, and God brought to pass their deliverance. This year you will be delivered.
Amen.
Financially you will be delivered.
Amen.
Spiritually you will be liberated.
Amen.
Anyone in captivity, today I decree your freedom in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This God, it changes times. It changes season for individual, for a person. And also, not only for a person, for a nation. He can do it. He has done it before. But eventually, you have failed. It happened in 2009. This year, I speak to you by the Spirit of the Living God. Your success will begin. Somebody say, my success begins now. I don't know what you have been through, but there is a God who can give a new beginning to people who are desirous of new beginning, to people who are looking for a new beginning, for people who have been crying unto him. Children of Israel, they cry unto God. Joseph believed that my Redeemer will come one day and deliver me. Will come one day and bring to pass my dream. He had the happy dreams. Dreams and affliction. Can you imagine? You have dreams that you will be the head. And every other thing will bow to you. But it was not coming to pass. Instead of it coming to pass, it was put in pit. From the pit, he went to Potiphar's house. From Potiphar's house, he was lying against. He went from one trouble to another trouble until he landed in prison. But God visited him in the prison. God will visit you.
Amen.
This year, God will visit you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We serve a God and we have a God in this church who is a changer of times, who is a changer of season. Who can do the impossible? Is the God, the God of all flesh. We think there is no impossibility. He can do and undo. He's the ancient of days. He's the beginning and the end. He's the Alpha and the Omega. He knows all things. He understands all things. He knows what to do. You may not know what to do. God knows what to do. He knows what to do about you. What to do about your children. What to do about your husband. What to do about your business. And this God says, I make all things new. Somebody say new.
Yeah.
I make all things new. Ladies and gentlemen, listen to this. There's no doubt that this year you will have a new beginning financially in Jesus' name.
Amen.
But there are things to do. If I were you, I will listen to this. There are things to do to speed up the arrival of a new beginning in your life. There are things to do. If I see any child crying, you're going to preach. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And we have heard that child will come to me here and begin to preach. You have a new beginning as a preacher. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Begin to preach with me. You receive anointing to preach. Amen.
Yeah.